Hi everyone, welcome you all for the webinar. Today we are going to present the WSO2 governance registry and WSO2 API managed integration. So I am Danesh Kurupu from the governance registry team, and my colleague Laladi Sureshika from API managed team will also join with me to conduct this webinar. So we will start the presentation now. Before we going into the presentation, I will like to walk through to the outline of our presentation. In our presentation, first we will talk about WSO2 governance registry and WSO2 API manager and its integration as an overview. So after the overview session, we will discuss about the different integration patterns without the API in feature installations. So after that, we will discuss about the dependency visualization across API and their services, etc. And after that, we will discuss about the subscription management and service visualization in governance registry store. Then finally, we will walk you to the one of the sample use cases with this API integration. So in our demonstration, we also prepare some demo for you to understand this feature installation properly. So in our demonstration, we are going to installation API manager features to the governance center, after that we will create web services and promote them to the web APIs through the registry life cycles, and we will walk through the governance center publisher and store, and we will consume services APIs from the governance center store. So let's start our presentation, and finally we will have a QA sessions also. So if you have any problems, please send your message so that we will can answer those things. So first, before we going into the integration part, let's have a quick overview about what is governance registry and how it is used in the SOA architecture. So first, WSO2 governance registry provides enterprise end-to-end SOA governance service. So if it is enable IT professional to streamline application development, testing, deployment processes, etc. So that it is easy for the professionals to govern all those their assets, APIs, and all. So it includes store, manage, search of any kind of enterprise assets, including services, APIs, projects, application, etc. So, and other thing is we have the capability to secure the access to the assets through the permission model, and we also have notification support, lifecycle management with multiple lifecycle support. And the main thing is we have the enterprise store publisher views, which have the rich and enhanced user experience. So if you go to the governance registry website, these features are listed there also. So I would like to focus your attention towards our governance center, which is newly introduced in our governance registry. In previous version, we only have the management console, but in our new releases, we have addition to the management console, we have publisher, store UI, publisher. So our the management console is only for administration task, which means user creation, user management, and lifecycle creation, asset type creation, etc. So admin configuration only done through the admin console. So if you are a developer or an asset owner, you should direct it to the publisher UI. So the publisher UI is for the users who are developing the API. So if you are a application user, so your UI endpoint should be the store UI. So the store UI will be provide you all the asset discovery, etc. So in addition to that, we have REST and SOAP APIs, so that you don't need to go to the UI, and you can directly call the REST and SOAP APIs available in the governance registry. So for the API manager part, I will hand over this to Lalaji. She will walk through the API management.
Thanks, Danish. Hi, everybody. I'm Lalaji Sureshika, Associate Technical Lead, currently working as a team member of WSO2 API Manager team. So let's start with a brief introduction on WSO2 API Manager. WSO2 API Manager is a complete open source solution for designing, creating, and publishing API assets. Sharing the APIs among developer community and allowing to do subscription for those APIs also a part of that API Manager product. And additionally, it provides scalable runtime traffic. It's a WSO2 platform inbuilt solution in which features have leveraged from production-ready security governance and integration components such as WSO2 Enterprise Service Bus, WSO2 Identity Server, and WSO2 Governance Registry. API Manager is fully focused on the API asset type by covering all its aspects as governing its life cycle from the API creation point and managing its runtime usage with applications, such that since the API is also an asset type, it's really a good use case to integrate API asset governance part into the governance registry inbuilt governance center. This is the exact requirement came from governance registry users, and it's what we are going to present in this webinar. So there are two ways of integrating API Manager capabilities with governance registry. First approach, as explained in this diagram, is external integration. In this scenario, governance registry publishes store apps, and API Manager publishes store apps will run in two separate JVMs. And the services created in the governance registry can be promoted as APIs in a running external API store. This way, the governance lifecycle of a service will manage from governance registry, while the promoted runtime API lifecycle will be handled from WSO2 API Manager. This integration will be useful if your organization want to have separate views to manage governance assets separately and manage API assets separately, which exposed to external API consumers. The other integration approach is keeping the governance registry server as the common governance center to govern all the asset types, including APIs. This way, there will be only one JVM, which is governance registry, used as the central publisher and store. And API Manager features has to be installed into governance registry server. Since WSO2 platform is built on OSGI framework, it's easy to separate component capabilities as features. For example, let's say in the API Manager store and publisher features, and then install them on top of any WSO2 product. a user can integrate API asset to Jira governance center by installing API manager features and use one common governance center publisher and store to govern API lifecycle and manage its subscriptions. This integration comes in handy, say when a user login to governance registry publisher app and start with storing SOAP or REST web services, and then he's trying to promote that service to an API via its lifecycle. Then to manage the promoted API, he can use the same governance center UI without pointing to external API manager instance. This way, governance registry will have the publisher store components, and still to handle the API runtime, we will need external API manager gateway and a key manager instance. In the next few slides, Danesh will go through a demonstration on this. Either you can promote existing services as APIs, and also you can create an API from scratch also. It can be either through a Swagger definition or manually, like the users doing it in API Manager 1.0 releases, and then do subscription management from governance store. From a general API Manager distributor setup, the differentiate on this feature installation on governance registry deployment is, instead of keeping separate API Manager instances to publish and store, we are using governance registry instances. So this will, in this way, there will be a common publish and store for all the metadata models, like APIs, visuals, models, SOAP or REST services or policies. But as I mentioned earlier, still you need gateway and key manager. So now the question coming, why we need API manager feature installation on governance registry? First important point is, in an organization, it can keep one-stop governance center for all the metadata models, including APIs. There are two applications in governance center, as explained by Danesh previously. The publisher will act as the central UI place where user navigate and manage assets throughout their life cycles, and the store will act as the central portal available for users to discover different asset types. And also, governance center store will facilitate social interactions as well. In terms, governance center means a common place for a user to govern multiple metadata models with managing its life cycle and do associations with other assets. This will help to govern all the assets from common publisher and explore all the assets from a central store. The second important of this deployment is, this will help leveraging governance features for API assets. For example, we do provide visualization of dependencies across APIs and other metadata, such as services visuals. You will see a demonstration on this aspect also in coming slides. Additionally, we do have integrate registry-based lifecycle support for API asset. Thus, it can be easily customized and extended. For example, a user can define custom lifecycle executors for API state transitions. The other thing is, now a user can add multiple life cycles for an API asset. For example, there can be different environments which need to control from same API asset, and from governance registry 5. Version onwards, we do allow on keeping multiple life cycles per one API asset based on this environment. Governance registry inbuilt publish and store apps has been implemented with the aid of our in-premise asset management product called WSO2 Enterprise Store. The API manager features installed in governance registry contain revamped API manager publisher store UIs built on top of this enterprise store. It has used latest technologies as Caramel framework, which is an inbuilt JavaScript MVC framework, and JavaScript jQuery handlebar template support, such that it provides easy customizations to extend the UIs, and it's also support very rich UI. So these are the basic advantages over this deployment. So now I am going to hand over to Danesh to go through the demo.
Hi again. Since you are now have the basic understanding about what is API integration means, I'd like to walk with you with the feature installations of API manager for governance registry. In feature installation, we need to first add the P2 repository for our servers, and you need to again consider that governance registry 5.1.0 is compatible with API manager publisher and store 2.0.1 version. So I will quickly go through the feature installation first. Here I started fresh governance registry pack so I will login as admin user here because I need some administration tasks to be done. So here you can see that in the default governance registry we are not providing API artifact type. So if you need any API type operation, we need to install the API manager features provided in the P2 repo. So first, if you need to install features, you need to go to the configure tab, and inside the configure, we need to go to the features click. So once you click on the features, you will get this UI. Since there are no feature reports, we need to add new repo in the server. So you need to click on the add repo. You can give any name for this. I just create set as repo. So the URL should be the P2 repo of our latest version. So I just copy that URL and paste it to the URL version. So it is just now we need to click on add button. It will take some time to install the repository in our governance registry server. Yes, now it is installed, so that you can discover the features available for the governance registry by clicking on find features. So that you can see there are few features including the API manager, API publisher and store. There you can see there are two versions, 2.0.0 and 2.0.1. Since we are using 5.1.0 for this demo, I will install the latest one in the publisher and the store. And you need another consideration that here we have two Kerbin runtimes, Kerbin 4.4.1 and 4.4.2. since our features are running in on top of 441 carbon runtime, we need to untick the other version 442. The same thing we need to follow in the carbon store API store as well. After that, in the bottom, there is a link called install. So we need to click on that. So after that, you will see the number of features going to install with those API store and publisher. Just need to click on next. Next, you will go to the license agreements. You need to accept that and click on next. This will also take some time to install the features. After the installation, it will give a message saying that it is successful and we need to restart the server to enable those features in the governance registry server. From this feature installation, we will add new API asset types and new lifecycle configurations for the API management and some store and publisher UI, custom UIs. So I will walk through those installations once the installation done. Okay, and now the features are successfully installed. Now you need to click on next, restart, to restart the server. I will click on restart now. This will take some time to restart the server. Once restart, we can refresh the server and see whether the features are installed correctly. Yes, now we start already restarted now. Just click on the refresh the server and logging as admin user. Now if I go to the main tab, you can see API types is created. If you go to the extensions and go to the life cycles, you can see new API lifecycle is added to the server. And if you go to the artifact types, you can see API, a new artifact called API is added. So the installation is now correctly installed. So we can again go to, we will go to the presentation. So we will done this step. We have already installed the features. So our next demonstration will depends on this deployment setup. I will quickly go through the setup so that you can understand the configuration. First, we have the GREX server and it is in the API manager 201 features are installed in the GREX server. And we also have a API manager server, which is 191 instance, which is attached gateway and the key manager. GREX server will act as the publisher and the store. And we also already set up API 3DB servers, one for API MDB, one for the user store part, other one for the registry DB. Those three the databases are shared among those instances to perform the integration and configuration part. There are some other configurations need to be done for the API manager XML, registry XML and those stuff. These configurations are stated in the WSO2 documents, which is the link appeared in the below. So I'm not going to configure those because of the time limitation we have in the webinar. So I will pre-configure those in the for Gregg instance and API instance. So I will quickly go through walk through the demonstration with those configurations. So for our demonstration, first what I'm going to do is we first create SOAP service and REST service in the governance publisher and walk through the LC lifecycle executor, and finally I will publish those services as APIs to the publisher. So for that we need to change the service lifecycle configuration and need to add new executor for the publish event, so that once it is published it will automatically create an API from the service metadata and publish those APIs to the governance publisher. So with the API stored to executor, we need some parameters as well. So API manager endpoint will be the publisher endpoint, and username password will be the login user password, and the tier, etc. So I will, from this point, I will continue with the demo so that you can get the idea about this, what the usefulness of these feature installations. Let's go to the server which we have already been configured. I will log in as the admin user here. So first I will go to the service lifecycle and show you with about these configuration changes in the service lifecycle. So you can see that in the service lifecycle, in state ID production state, in the publish event, I set the executor as API stored to executor. Inside that, I configure those parameters so that it will publish the service metadata to API. So our configuration is done. So our management console starts is over now. Now I will go to the, log it to the publisher as the publisher user. I just create a user called pub user, and I will log in as the pub user here. So this is our publisher landing page. There you can see service, SOAP service and REST service asset types. And I'm after the feature installation, we have another asset type called APIs here. So once we go to the services, SOAP services, there are few I preloaded those services so that you can see those see the services. For us, I will create a new service to our demonstration. I will do it through the through WSDL upload. So click on add, and you can either go to the manually created one or create a SOAP service using the WSDL. I will walk you through the creating through the WSDL path. So just click continue so that you can. You have two options. You can either import the WSDL to URI, or you can upload it to a file. So I will click on the URI option, and I have a WSDL URI, weather WSDL URI. Just copy that one and paste it to the URI section. So the name will automatically filled by the WSDL name. Otherwise, you can put any name as you wish. I will keep it as it is. So I will set my version as 100. It also can be set to another any values. So I will click on create button to create the SOAP service. So it is created. We need to wait. So our global weather WSDL file is uploaded. Once we click on the WSDL file, it will go to the detail page of the WSDL file. So you can see the name of the WSDL and version. Media type is set correctly, and the content of the WSDL is also shown in the detail page of the WSDL. So that now you can go to the SOAP service. There you can see at the bottom newly created services appeared, and it is in the development state now. So once we click on that, we will go to the detail page. In the detail page at the bottom, we can see the association for the WSDL for the SOAP service. So once you click on the show dependency in the SOAP service, walk to the dependency view graph. There you can see that SOAP service is associated with the WSDL file and its endpoint. So, and now I will go to the lifecycle state. It is now in the development state. I need to promote that into the production state, so that in the production we can publish that SOAP service as a API. So I will walk through that one. Just click on promote. Now it is in the testing state. Now I will promote again. Now it is in the production state, so that you have two options, either to publish the SOAP service or to demote. I will click on publish. So once you click on publish, the new API should create, and that API should associated with the existing our SOAP service. We will click on publish. So you can see the state is updated successfully. So once we once go to the overview page of the service and click on the show dependencies, you can see that additional another new association is added to the SOAP service. That means that is our API, which is created, which is state that created by association. So we have the previous one also, so that we can compare those things. So I will remove that one. So if you go to the API section, you can see the newly created API with the SOAP service metadata. So you can see all those things. Now I will walk you through the web service also. So here also we can click on add button. Here also we can do either for WSDL upload, or Saga upload, or manual. I will select the manual path and just continue that. And here we need to fill the name, context, version, and endpoint, etc. So I have some notes. So I will just copy that one and create a REST service. I will create Wikipedia API and our context will be / Wikipedia. And our version will be 100. It can be changed also. And I will add another a description also for this. And I will also add the endpoint to that. Say dev endpoint URL should be okay. Now we will click on the create button to create the REST service. You can see the newly created Wikipedia API is shown in the bottom of the list page. So once you click on the that, we will go to the detail page. So here also I will click on the dependencies. Since they are we have manually created, now there is no association attached to the REST service. And now I will go again to the lifecycle and promote the service to the production state. So we are in the testing state now, and again click on promote. Now we are in the production. Again, as we done for the SOAP service, we will click on publish to create the API. So it is now created, and the lifecycle state is promoted to the publish to API store now. So once you again go to the overview part, you will see the dependencies for this. Here you can see API REST service is associated with Wikipedia API now. So I will remove those things. And now we'll go to the API governance store and see whether those APIs are shown here. We'll click on that. We will also log into as okay. If you click on the APIs, there are nothing shown in the APIs because still those created APIs are in the created state in the publisher. So we need to go to another API lifecycle and push those APIs to the public state to show it in the store. So I will create, I will first get the Wikipedia API and click on edit button. And there I will promote this one to go to the implementation state, and you can either select manage API or prototype. I will select prototype and add the production endpoints here. I will set the production endpoint as Wikipedia/api.php. So I will click on manage. Here you can select tire availability. I just click gold here, and the transport is HTTP and HTTPS. So after that, I will click on save and publish. Now the API is published successfully. Now if you go to the APIs and refresh the API list, you will see Wikipedia API is attached to that. And also if you go and add some tags on it, if we add some tags, Wiki API, and save it, you can see those tags in our governance store tag cloud, so that we can search from those tags also. So now we have created the API. Now we need to add new application and subscribe this API to our application. For that, we need to go to the My Application tab. So we can create application with any name here. We will create Wiki app as a name and select the total entire as gold and click on add. Application is now created successfully, and at the bottom of the page you can see that application named Wiki app is created, and you can even edit or delete from this page. So again, we will go to the API and you need to subscribe our API to that application. So I will click on the Wiki app and the gold and click on subscribe. So you have successfully subscribed to the API, and I will go to the my subscription page. So you can here you can generate keys for our application. So if you click on generate keys, you can see access token, customer key, customer secrets have created now. So once you click on the subscribe applications, and you can test this application from the governance store itself, from the API console. Once you click on the API console, Saga UI will be appeared. So here you can see we have already subscribed to the Wiki application in the production key. So our key is automatically populated in the console. So once you click on get and try it, just wait a second, we need to configure SSL here. We will try it again. Now we have configured the browser now. Now let's try it again. We will go search to the curl message to see whether it performed correctly. So and click on that. The problem is there is a problem in the SSL in the backend server configuration. So since it is time consuming, we will skip those testing part. I will walk through the other API and show you the process as well. So once we go to the other API, again API, so you can see that Wikipedia API is now in the public state. That's why we can see it in the governance store also. So you can, we can create the global weather service also a public state, so that it will also appear in the governance store. So here we can add some descriptions and some tags. And click on next implementation. And again, I will create a manage API and our UI should be endpoint URL should be this. And copy that one. And you can test the URL also. It is valid. And click on manage. Here also we can click on any tier availability. Tier availability means how many requests can be served for the API. And we can select the transport prototypes also. Now we can select, save and publish here. And again, it is successful. If you go to the store, you can see the newly created API also. Now you can see there's about three tags. API is the common one for both APIs. These two are created for each one. So if we click on weather, it will filter out the APIs which tagged as weather. If we click on API, since it is tagged in both APIs, it will both APIs is shown in the picture. So if we click on wikis, it will show the only the Wikipedia APIs now. So this global weather API also has have the same lifecycle promotion and create subscription. These applications are all the same. Since we have a SSL problem in the server side, we couldn't test the published API for now. So I will go to presentations again. So I've done those these demo demonstration. I'll already publish the REST service SOAP and REST service to the LC executor, and I'll show the visualization graph in the publisher UI. And publisher, since we have installed the API features in the governance registry, you can follow either one. You can create API through manual process, you can create through Sagger, or you can create through any SOAP and REST services, and go into the lifecycle state. And I'll show that show the manage APIs and how we publish to the API store and gateway. And I also shown you that the consuming services in the governance center store. I show the how applications are new applications are created, and how the sub how we subscribe the API to those applications, etc. And I also this one is the one we missed here, but probably it is, we can test it through different things. One is for API console, which is provided in the API store. Other one is the REST client provided in the different browsers, and also we can do it in the curl command also. So that's it for the demonstration. Finally, I will go walk you through the sample use case with this feature installation. So let's say a use case about there's an organization which have multiple teams, and each team has their own API runtime work as shown in the picture. And also each team have multiple environments. Let's say team one have their environments as dev environment, QA environment, production environment, etc. And each team has those kinds of environments. So the organization will have the requirement of have a central governance body, so that every API is published in each environment and each team will be governed through one governance center server, so that everyone should create the API through that central governance body. And from the lifecycle state, we can publish those APIs to the different environments depending on their criteria. Maybe the user, some parameters created by the user. So etc. So these kind of use cases can be easily configured through this API integration, and you need very few configuration changes in the lifecycle aspect and the API and service lifecycle aspect. So that's it for the use case. For the future improvements, we are now working on the integration statistic in the that statistical dashboard view to the API runtime. It is because if API, we need to collect the API statistics, runtime statistics from the API usage, and those statistics should be shown in the central dashboard. To get a clear picture about the runtime consumption of those APIs. Next one is the tenant sharing capability. That means once the API created by one tenant user, and that API need to be shared to among one or more tenant domains, we need to give the capability of that. That is also another thing we are working on these days. The final one is the integration administrative UI. That means we need to have central administrative UI to configure workflow, approval process, team upload, etc. So that is what we are focusing for the future improvements of our governance store with integration with the API manager. So that's it. If you have any question, we can give few more minutes for that.
Okay, so there's one question. I read the question first. In the deployment, is it possible to physically separate the GREC publisher and GREC store so that store can go in GMC independent of publisher? Yes. Actually, for simplicity, in today's webinar, we use same governance registry server to keep as the publisher and store. But in case if you need to split those two, yes, you can. And if you want the API manager features also installed there, so what you have to do is in one governance registrar, you have to install only the publisher features, and in the second one, you have to install only the store features. So that way, that will handle the separation.
We have another question. I will read out the question first. Can I get an API to improve my service life cycle? That means you need a governance REST API or REST APIs to change the life cycle configurations. So it is possible. We have already have some governance APIs to do configurations, etc., without using the governance UI. So it is possible through the governance API and REST APIs provided by the governance registry.
And there's another question that asking whether is that customizations are possible like in API Manager current release packs. Yes, I suppose that question means the UI customization. Yes, with Enterprise Store framework, it's easy to do customizations. Here we have implement our API manager integration also as an extension. So if you want to do some CSS styling like those things, it's easily can be done. So yes, answer is yes. So seems those are the questions for today. So thank you very much for joining with us. So if you have further questions, please contact through our website. Thank you very much.